Good morning, everyone. I've handed out colour-coded annotated poems, and I've underlined in colour-coded the themes set of the quotes that I'll be discussing, but that also be projected on the board. Today I'm going to be talking about Plath's use of imagery in Daddy and Lady Lazarus, specifically focusing on how her life and her feelings are projected through this. Sylvia Plath was an American poet who suffered from depression and self-doubt throughout her teenage years and adult life, ending in her suicide in 1963. She had a troubled relationship with her father, and even though he died when she was young, it tormented her throughout her life. Her confused feelings from being torn between guilty about hating him and wanting his attention affected her relationships with men. When she later married a fellow poet, Ted Hughes, she felt oppressed, and when he cheated on her, it confirmed her anger and distrust for male authority figures. These aspects of her life and her tortured feelings were most evident in the poems Hughes published after her death in the volume called Ariel, where the imagery reveals how pathologically the past is connected to the present. Looking at the imagery of Lady Lazarus and Daddy, it reveals her downward spiral towards suicide and her feelings of impotent rage towards the two central male figures in her life. Both poems offer a dark connection between her personal torment at feeling oppressed and abused and the more universally acknowledged torture and oppression of the Jews at the hands of the Nazis, complicated by the fact that her father was German. Imagery is a key element to understanding and appreciating poetry, as poetry is a condensed form, so the imagery provides layers and suggesting gives more depth to the condensed form. Plath's imagery is central to these poems, and they are images which are formed in her mind, which haunt and obsess her. She uses images to conjure up and attempt to exorcise her demons, but in both poems discovers that once she has confronted them, what she has made into her inner life, as she writes in the final words of Daddy, "I'm through." Similarly to Lady Lazarus, when she refers to being brought back to life after a suicide attempt, "Nevertheless, I am the same identical woman." This can be read as less triumphant and more along the lines that even though she was resurrected, she is still the same suicidal woman. And the imagery in both poems suggests these angry words do not help her come through to a better place. The simple monosyllabic words reveal that now she has paraded and attacked all of these images, she is nothing. Shortly after this poem, she killed herself. That she isn't anything solid and real, but is broken up into different selves, is also reflected in the imagery, as well as the tone and incongruous rhythms and the language of these two poems. Incongruous against the dark, troubled content and imagery. There are so many different images of herself and Lady Lazarus, and her father and husband and daddy, and all of them fit together, while nothing or anything solid by themselves. That is her problem. In Lady Lazarus, Plath reflected a very fractured and disintegrating self after failed suicide attempts when she was younger. She structures the poem around these suicide attempts, beginning with the latest and then recalling images of earlier attempts, while capturing what it feels like to be brought back to life, prodded by doctors, and being viewed by an audience always as an object of sensationalist interest. The varying voices half mock and half rage about her failed efforts, while the imagery show how each decade and each attempt resulted in a more disturbed and fractured psyche, until she felt resurrected, but empty and powerless, just snapping at the empty air as she came back to life. The imagery of Lazarus also moves to the biblical story of resurrecting Lazarus from the dead as a miracle, but a miracle to establish his own power. In both poems, Daddy and Lady Lazarus, Plath uses imagery of male authority figures to suggest they are all-powerful God figures. "Hear God, hear Lucifer," she cries after her resurrection, and warns them that she will rise like a phoenix, another resurrection image. So her poem is called Lady Lazarus to reflect her gender issues and desire to be empowered as a woman in the decades of male patriarchy. "Out of the ash I rise with my red hair, and I eat men like air." Although the imagery suggests that she will rise with vengeance to attack the men who oppress her, with the verb rise, The simile of eating men like air is an empty threat, because gulping air is gulping nothing, suggesting that she snaps at them but misses their centre. Another image suggesting that her actions, therefore herself, have no solid reality. This is a powerful use of bathos in the imagery, similar to the effect of calling her monster father daddy. Disintegration is a major theme in Sylvia Plath's imagery and is linked to death and rotting. Soon, soon, the flesh, the grave cave ached will be at home on me. The repetition of soon is almost beckoning death, while the image of home suggests that she finds something comforting and safe and cosy. While linked with the image of grave, it gives the reader a shocking image of how, for her, the idea of being comfortable and safe would be to be under a grave. The oral imagery is effective in the assonance of grave, cave, ache, and the control is evident in the urgent enchantment. In Daddy, Plath uses imagery to exorcise her demons. Her memories of her father, who she once worshipped, became to see as tyrannical and cruel. She uses death imagery to conjure up the worst images of him and metaphorically kill them, so she is set free of those images. However, the memories of her father become the memories of her husband Hughes, another oppressive man. And when she raises these images, she finds that without them, she is nothing, as they have killed her off instead. She refers to death in a suicide attempt, "Get back to you," as her father died when she was little, claiming she felt even the bones would do. But when this failed, she felt that she was only stuck together with glue, another image of disintegration and feeble resurrection. The darkest imagery in these poems is connected to the death through torture and suffering. In the poems, Plath's personae link themselves to Jews' horrible suffering in the concentration camps at the hands of the Nazis. This imagery fuses together significant cultural, historical, and biblical images of suffering and the ongoing relationship between torturer and tortured in personal lives. Plath's speakers use imagery of Belsen and other camps because it is imagery that has become archetypal in the last 60 years. The imagery is controversial, but it does use her experience to touch on wider themes of oppression that, through imagery that haunts us all. In Lady Lazarus, she refers to her skin when resurrected as bright as a Nazi lampshade in a horrific illusion of how the Nazis made objects through Jews' organs. So that just shows that the skin is stretched so tight. And this can also be linked to how she felt, so stretched with the light shining on her at all times. This is also apparent in the imagery of her being a freak at the sideshow. "Gentlemen, ladies," she calls out, like a fairground barker. Later in the structure tree, she refers to selling herself as relics, like suffering saints, a large charge for a piece of my hair. She extends the victim imagery to how the public gape at corporate suicide victims brought back to life. The peanut crunching crowd captures the sound of the onomatopoeia, giving the image of a nightmarish oral quality, which she does in both poems. It does suggest a paranoid mind believing that her fate is on par with a Holocaust victim, but her persona do half parody that a raging childish girl who sees her life in Holocaust imagery. In Dali, the Holocaust imagery occurs again. She links her father to Hitler's appearance that links him very directly to not only the Nazis, but referring to his neat moustache, his black boot, and his Aryan eye, and the German Air Force. In the image of neat moustache, which instantly alludes to Hitler's moustache, the adjective neat is sharp and harsh because of the sound of the T. At the end, the crisp monosyllable is onomatopoeic, raising harsh, quick behaviour of Hitler and the fascist. Another strong image Plath uses is colour, which she uses effectively to relate to her feelings and emotions. In Lady Lazarus, Plath uses the colour gold and pure gold baby as an image of purity and perfection, while she quickly contrasts this with that melts to a shriek. Using the two verbs melt and shriek show that something that was once so beautiful can be completely slipped through the fingers and turned into something as painful and as horrible as a shriek. Colour is most strongly used in Dali, and I personally think it is one of the most effective uses of imagery in her poetry. She uses the colour black in "So black no sky can squeak through." In this imagery, the colour becomes so thick it's blanking out all the light, which can be referenced to her life as how her emotions blanked out all the goodness in her life and she just couldn't see it. And the onomatopoeia of squeak is similar to one last cry for help. The use of onomatopoeia highlights the oral quality of Sylvia Plath's imagery. She always says that her poems should be read aloud. Black is used throughout the poem in a foreshadowing way, starting with the black shoe that provides the image of being confined in the shadows and not being able to see a light. Later, in Any Less Black, the man who bit my pretty red heart in two, is a strong comparison image of black versus such a strong, vibrant colour as red, as though she was once vibrant, but now she is poor and white. The verb bit is vulgar and horrific, and the adjective pretty is quite girlish and cute, which when paired together provides a strong and foul image, which once again demonstrates how Plath's imagery relate to her life and the way she feels that her father ruined her innocence when she was younger. Plath uses a web of imagery to string together to form who she is, but she is never whole. Her poetry would not be as personal without the imagery, as they provide a secret insight to her mind and how she's feeling. And it's so tragic that such a gifted poet had to die so young. Thank you.